Will WhatsApp leave India? It might sound unimaginable to you. After all, WhatsApp is everywhere. More than 400 million Indians use it every month. We conduct business over WhatsApp, speak to family and friends, plan meetings and trips. So life without WhatsApp may sound impossible. But a new case could change all of that. In 2021, the government of India published new IT rules. Every social media company has to follow these rules. But one provision is being challenged. WhatsApp has taken the matter to the Delhi High Court. It was their lawyer who issued this warning. He said in court that WhatsApp could leave India. So what exactly is this provision in the IT rules and why is it so controversial? The IT rules talk about the first originator of information. Say there's a piece of fake news or a hate message on WhatsApp. Under the IT rules of India, WhatsApp must trace where this message came from, who drafted it first. And this person or account is called the first originator. Now, who can force WhatsApp to do this? Any court or competent authority? The idea is to ensure that fake news does not cause trouble, that the real culprits are traced and punished. But WhatsApp has flagged an issue. The messages you send on WhatsApp are encrypted, so only two people can read them, the sender and the receiver. Not even WhatsApp knows what you have sent. So the company says, we cannot follow these IT rules. To find the originator, we must break encryption. And breaking encryption equals breaking privacy. At least that's what WhatsApp is saying. What about the government of India? In the past, the IT ministry has rejected this argument. They say the likes of WhatsApp already mine user data, so they cannot claim to be guardians of privacy. Well, it's a fair point. But the question is, will the court agree? Similar petitions have been filed across the country. All of them have been clubbed together at the Delhi High Court. They will start hearing the case in the month of August. Now, this is a very complicated issue. On the one hand, you have the right to privacy. The Supreme Court has said it's a fundamental right. On the other, you have national interest. What if fake news affects public order? What if it leads to social unrest? What if it targets children? Surely there must be accountability. Courts have said that fundamental rights are not absolute. There must be reasonable curbs. The question is, do the IT rules satisfy that yardstick, or does the risk outweigh the benefit? That's one question the courts must consider. Secondly, do other countries do something like this? The judge put this question to WhatsApp's lawyer. He said, there is no such rule anywhere else in the world. Some countries did try, like the FBI in the United States. They asked Apple to unlock iPhones belonging to suspects, but Apple denied. It led to a huge legal showdown in the US, so India's rules are one of a kind, which is why it was always going to be a very consequential lawsuit. And WhatsApp has just raised the stakes. Let me quote from what their lawyer said. This is the WhatsApp lawyer. He said, as a platform, we are saying, if we are told to break encryption, then WhatsApp goes. We will have to keep a complete chain of messages, and we don't know which ones will be asked to be decrypted. It means millions and millions of messages will have to be stored for a number of years. So WhatsApp is building a strong case and they're looking to fight this out. The question is, what happens next? Let's assume that the court sides with the government of India. It says WhatsApp must break encryption. Then the company has two choices. One, it can comply with the order, but chances are it will open the floodgates. Countries across the world will then draft similar laws and they too will ask WhatsApp to break encryption. And if it's WhatsApp today, it could be Apple and others next. Which brings us to the second choice for WhatsApp, the choice to leave India. But will WhatsApp really abandon its biggest market? They make around $1 billion from India. Can the company just walk away from that? Like I said, the stakes are pretty high in this case. Courts and governments around the world will be watching this.